Has Apple killed off Facebook ad retargeting? Be sure to stick around until the end. I actually figured out a secret strategy to retarget people who've opted out of being tracked. Before we jump into that though, it's important that you understand what exactly is happening with retargeting with iOS 14. So here's how things used to work for every single user. You'd place a thing called a Facebook pixel on your website, and this would allow you to both track and optimize for all sorts of behaviors. So this could be visiting specific pages, spending a lot of time on the website, adding something to the cart, initiating checkout, all of that. So what you could do is take all that data and then make custom audiences to show ads to. So you could show ads just to people who added something to their cart or visited a specific page. You could also create lookalike audiences. So find people who are very, very similar to those that took those specific actions. The pixel was also fairly accurate at tracking those different behaviors and optimizing for them. So if you had people click on an ad and then make a purchase, it would get better and better at finding other similar people who would also make a purchase. So on Apple iOS devices, people can now opt out of being tracked, and this is coming to Android devices as well, and may impact like 80% of the platform, which is insane. So how does opting out impact retargeting? Well, for people who've opted out, you still put that pixel on your website, and it still gathers that initial data and can optimize your campaign because it is still tracking like purchases and things like that. It's not nearly as accurate as it used to be, and I've noticed it can have trouble optimizing, but it is gathering that data. But it can't pass it back to Facebook, so you cannot make any custom audiences based off that. But they won't be included in any audiences that are related to that pixel, including audiences of people who visited a specific page, as well as lookalike audiences and anything website related. Part of the reason this is such a big deal is people very rarely buy the first time they see an ad. They'll likely click on the ad and then a few days will go by. Maybe they'll go back, add it to the cart. It's usually a sales cycle that's like 2 days to 30 days or sometimes even longer. So someone could click on your ad, almost finish checkout, but because they've opted out of tracking, they're not gonna get added to any retargeting audiences and they likely won't see your ad again. That is, unless you're using my secret strategy for retargeting people who've opted out. Let's jump into that now, and then I'll cover every useful retargeting audience you should be using in iOS 14. So we're gonna show them a series of three videos, and for the first video, we're only gonna show this video to people who on the Facebook page, it's a custom audience, have clicked a call to action button. So we're really trying to keep each call to action as a valuable website visit. Therefore, you know that each website click is gonna go into this audience, but this is really a part of the Facebook behavior, so you can actually use this to retarget people who have opted out. And we're going to exclude our website visitors because I have a separate retargeting campaign specifically for website visitors and add to cart and for people who actually we can track. So the only people in this audience are people who clicked a link to the website and then are not being tracked as a website visitor. So you can do a series like this on general website sales or brand, or you can do it for specific different products where you kind of lead people down a line based off a specific product if they keep watching the videos. So the only people who will receive the second video are people who watched half of the first video. So that first video only had people who weren't being tracked as website visitors but did click a link. And then people who watched more than half of that will get shown the second video. And then I am excluding people who've watched any of the third video because people who watch the third video will have seen half of the second video. So we want to actually move them along in line. So you can do this with as many videos as you want and as many products as you want. Yeah, just people who watched half of video two. And it's important for the first two to be videos because then you can do 50% video views, where this one can be photos and things like that. And it can be multiple ads. So this is just for one product, but you could easily build this out where you have the sequence going for like five products, six different products, bust every objection, feature new testimonials, only for people who clicked a link, weren't tracked, and continue to watch videos on that subject. There is actually a kind of complex way to only show ads to people who opted out of tracking and clicked a link, and then show an additional ad to people who clicked a link again. And the way that's set up, basically what you do is show ads to people who clicked a link 2 days ago and exclude people who clicked a link 1 day ago. So they click on a link, 1 day goes by, then they're shown this video ad and you exclude people who did the website visits. And the reason you want to set it up like that is then in the next one, what you can do is only show the ads to people who clicked 1 day ago. So they would have had to have clicked again. So they had to have seen the video and then clicked in the last day. So they saw the video that we showed to people who'd clicked 2 days ago, and then they clicked again and they're gonna receive this special offer or video or photo or things like that. And then we're gonna exclude people in the 2 to 30 day window just so it's not complex with them like bouncing back and forth between the different videos and things like that. So if someone's seen this one, you know they've opted out of tracking, watched video one, even just a couple seconds, but then done a second click showing additional interest. So briefly, let's look at exactly what retargeting is allowed and what is not. So anything here, this is for targeting new people. You can do all this detailed targeting, location, age, things like that. It's when we get into the custom audiences where we have issues. So you're gonna run into issues if you're trying to retarget people who are visiting the website or doing specific behavior on the app or offline activity that is tracking, because this is off of the Facebook platform. So you can't actually retarget people who, let's say, took a specific action on your website. You can do like a customer list or an email list where you can actually manually update that, because it's your data and you're just connecting that person to the profile. There's actually some email platforms and e-commerce platforms where it's integrated with Facebook and able to pass that data between the two. This would achieve more or less the same thing as you uploading your customer list and your email list to the platform consistently. If you can include a conversion value in your customer list, this will really help you for creating audiences and building out lookalikes. Facebook sources, so you can use all of these, which is really amazing. The ones I use most commonly is video, Instagram account, and Facebook page. So you can still retarget people who watch specific videos, either ones you posted organically on your page or videos you ran as an ad. I usually want people to watch at least 25 to 30 seconds. So if it's a shorter video, I'll usually do 95%. If it's a longer one, I'll do like 50 or occasionally 25. So you can create that audience. And if the video is on a specific topic or about a specific product, you can kind of retarget people with other things related to that product. I found the leads on Facebook to be low quality, but you can retarget people from the lead forms. I do think the shopping experience is gonna move more and more on the Facebook platforms, where people aren't going to need to leave and can actually check out on Facebook. And that'll be a big way that they work around this tracking issue. With Instagram, you can still retarget people who engaged with any post, engaged with any ad, visited the account. So that's still a really valuable retargeting audience. And as we were using before, I love that Facebook specifically has people who clicked a call to action, because if you make all your call to actions the website, that means this person is very, very valuable. You're now the retargeting expert, and you want to go through my two videos that get you completely 100% set up for iOS 14, absolutely tracking everything, understanding everything. I also have a free checklist on my website that's completely free. I'll have a link down below, and I'll see you in that video.